blueprint of how.
Created for. That you can do it doesn't mean you were created for it. Doesn't mean you should build your life around it. Doesn't matter who says what to you. Now, everybody looks at you and says, you can do this, so therefore it must be this. The only person who gets to determine that really is you.
Ego and purpose does not coexist, but the environment you live in feeds your ego more than your purpose.
We're conditioned by what we see.
Yeah.
There's some of you who have limiting beliefs that you don't even know you have yet. Because of what you saw, what you experienced, you've healed some part, but it's like smoke, it's still around you. Smoke is around you or inside you, but there's smoke like palm oil. It doesn't, you don't play with palm oil. It's gonna touch different places. And so what you have seen is either you develop a deep resentment or you just took the behavior, but either way you're opposite side of the spectrum. You are responsible because you've allowed them this far. You've gone again and presented the idea and they shut it down, but you went again the second time, and you went again the third time, and you went again, and you keep on going. Because guess what? They have become your excuse. You have the fear, but you make them the excuse because it's easier to blame someone else.
Yes.
But you are the one that keeps going. Not them. They're allowed to say whatever they want to say.
Right.
But you keep going. Because somewhere in the back of your mind is an excuse you're looking for, and it's them. It's an inverted way of blaming someone. It's like, yeah, I kind of want to blame myself because it's been too wrong to look myself in the mirror and say I don't want to move. So let me blame my husband. Let me blame my father. Let me blame my boss. people who are telling you what to do. See, when they shuffle through their own dreams, they need birth either. They need birth either. So, I want to understand this. You're asking validation from someone at the same level of awareness or lower level of
awareness.
And expecting the person to somehow give you very informed decisions. And so someone else at the higher level of awareness comes and tells you to jump. And then guess what you do? You then go back to them and say, said I should jump. They were not in this class with you. For some of you, why would you want something like, no, I want you to coach you, but let me go ask my husband. Or I want you to go, let me go ask my mother. Or let me just talk about this to a friend. Let me just bounce ideas off. Some of your dreams have been killed because of bouncing ideas. Because you can't bounce ideas off someone at the same level of awareness or lower than you. You have to bounce your ideas off someone at a higher level of awareness than you. It's what is called borrowing relief. That guides to being aware of is that guys are a bit more critical about women's businesses than they are aware that they are. So when I do women's center, I actually have women crying when I talk about this because I'm like, I don't know that men know how critical they are when a woman brings their business to them. They think that, you guys think you're asking us a logical question. We hear it as critique. You think you're asking us like, you know, you're trying to help. But it's not help to us when you ask us a million and one question that we can answer. It's just like, so because a woman is often supportful, when you come with your idea, the woman support, the woman claps. Woman's nature to support, so she's like, even when she's the idea is crap, she's like, oh my, that's so mad. You know, how are we gonna do this? Well, there's the reverse. When a woman comes with an idea, most of the time, you guys start asking the questions like, so how are you gonna pay the stuff? What are you gonna do? How are you gonna do this? Why do you always do this? What do you do for that? Blah, blah, blah. It's popping up in your mind, but it's shutting down the dream. It's like literally, because the truth is she doesn't have the answer that you're asking. And in fact, some of you know that she can't give me the answers. Remember when I said that the boss opened my business for me but he opened for his wife? He was asking his wife all the questions, he wouldn't even ask me. How are you gonna pay the staff? Where are you gonna work? How are you gonna take care of the children? I'm taking care of the children, and I'm working on the business, blah, blah, blah. Look. That business will help you. Lighter club than you would. Because men are harder than themselves. Like, it's not you're not doing to, you do it to yourself, that's the problem. Like, the way you are talking, you do it to yourself, but sometimes you're also more forgiving of yourself. You forgive yourself a bit more easily than you forgive the other person. So, for now, and that's why communication helps. Sit down with the person and say, what am I doing to your business that you don't want to speak to your life? This thing, what would be different if I let it go? What are you feeling when I do this? Sometimes just asking, when you see the woman start to agitate, sometimes just asking, what are you feeling? Because of the questions I'm asking. I'm not asking in the lunch, I just want to know what you're feeling. Sometimes you'll be surprised by what just your one question makes the person feel. Inadequate. I've had men ask, in front of their wedding, what are you feeling when I'm asking? And the woman just says, inadequate. And that's what not the man's intention. But that's what the person is feeling because of the question. So again, if you're communicate. And I'm talking to all of you like you have wives because I assume that all of you are going to have wives. So sometimes you learn on the job, sometimes you learn before the job. However, when you learn, usually when you wake up is your morning. Alright, so what would be different if I let it go? Let me tell you another reason to let all the nitty-gritty details go when you're asking your spouses about their ideas. Women know how to deal with messes. That's why they handle babies well. It doesn't necessarily need to they will handle it. It doesn't need to add up the way it adds up to you. If it was adding up the way it adds up to you, then she would be a man, not a woman. And you won't leave her. But you want her to think like you, and it's not going to work. Sometimes it helps, but so many times it's not. Sometimes it helps you to ask the person what kind of support you need. Sometimes I'll just, as you need the support, just ask her, what kind of support do you need, and what can I do? Sometimes you don't need to ask her question. Because she herself is confused about that thing at that point. But women know how to handle confusion, which is why women know how to handle knowledge and confidence. Messes. So it might not add up, but they know how to profit from it. So maybe I'll see your mothers do it, just like, oh, this house is a mess. This kitchen is a mess. We don't think we have food. And then before you know it, there's food somewhere that's produced from all the ingredients you looked at that didn't look like it could produce anything. Tell you what the line is. Assume she knows the answer. Assume she knows the answer. When a woman comes in to share, she's sharing. Does she want your input? Yeah. Yes. She says she wants it. Always start from the premise of the assumption that she knows the answer. The problem is men jump in like there is a problem and she came to them, like you said, bring the foolscap, bring the Bible, and start writing. Because he didn't assume she knew the answer. If you assume first that she knows the answer, then what you are doing is playing supporting role rather than giving solutions to the problem. Or rather than, like what you said, I mean, like she does, assume, it's just an assumption. Assume she knows the answer. It's really, this is, you know, when you tell women to, so when I'm doing a seminar for women, I teach them how to think logically, how to present their ideas logically, because a woman is very emotional. When you present their ideas, she's like, oh, you know, I've always had this dream that children will stand and right now fall into their mouth and like, that's not in the logical proposition in the first place. So I teach them what they should do. But when I'm with men, I tell men, stop solving the problem. There is no problem. First, assume there is no problem. Then offer her the help if she comes to the problem. So assume she knows the answers. Because if you assume, let your response will be different if you assume that the person who is talking to you knows the answer. If I came to you with a business idea, it's separate from if your wife came to you with a business idea. If I came to you with a business idea and said, oh, Emmanuel, this venture I'm going into, because you have a perception of me, you already assume that I know some core fact. With the person we're spouse with, sometimes the closeness of the finish makes you forget that the person is an intelligent, resourceful person. It's human. It happens to all of us. It doesn't matter how intelligent you thought the person was. And even worse, women grow on men. So you might have married that person and she was clueless when you were married her. That's the pliability of women. That's why she's held. Women grow on men. Women can just pick up something in 1 year that was not there in their entire life. And all of a sudden, they become so much more intelligent than you even ever thought. First of all, with reasons. Second of all, you start wanting to do what you've always done, which is provide the solution. But at that point, she doesn't necessarily need it. But you are refusing to see that the dynamics has changed. Because what she wants is that, first of all, she wants you to recognize that she has grown, that she's intelligent, that people are coming to her. And with spousal arrangement, that's the worst time. The man doesn't even want to acknowledge it. That my wife is the next thing since sliced bread now. Because of maybe the way the relationship was before. There was a lady yesterday at the seminar and said, she's a widow now. She told my husband that if we found a drink water, that well, what type, what drink do you want? I don't know. He has to make a decision on what drink we're going to have, because that was, it's like, she's like, but I'm different now. In 3 years, close the gap. She didn't work at all before he died. Now, after he died, he was, you know, after now she's a lawyer in the legal department in the Ministry of Justice. She's doing a whole side hustle. Just open her firm. If, for instance, that man was alive, maybe he didn't die. Maybe she just came for a seminar and decided I want to do something in my life. The person the man married and the person she is now is coming different. If he doesn't recognize that what's going to happen is conflict, which is what happens a lot. Because I said growth separates. Growth separates while the people are there because the people refuse to acknowledge that growth has happened. Growth has happened. It's supposed to be a fantastic thing, but because we will not actually say what is going on our inside. We are going to be facing conflict until communication is done, until the man is vulnerable. So, to answer your question, assume that the woman knows the answer. Then offer her support. Like, imagine a woman comes to you with the idea, and then you say something like, oh, I'm afraid to have this idea, and you know that you can make a success out of it. You might not know all the dynamics, but if there's any particular point you need,
Could you be seeking validation?
Yes. That first of all, when she came to you for your back with her idea, she wasn't asking for solution, she was asking for validation. Women seek validation, not solution. First of all, they know it. They talk about the business. They might not know the language, your type of language, but they know how to make it work. Again, like I said, they know how to handle messes. And she's seeking your validation on men who are so stingy. Validation. Not when you're dating. When you're dating, you can give it all up. When is your wife? You're just like, oh, okay. Because what you're thinking of is all the other factors. Thinking of the children, you're thinking of the time, you're thinking of every other thing. And sometimes